The latest free update to Sea of Thieves is here, and with it, players will journey into a perilous new region, where they'll have to brace themselves against unpredictable earthquakes, dodge sudden blasts from superheated geysers, and run for their lives as volcanic eruptions send explosive rocks hurtling through the air. All of this and more as we set a course to land upon Forsaken Shores. With the Forsaken Shores update, a new region has been revealed within the Sea of Thieves, the Devil's Roar. A dangerous, unpredictable volcanic landscape that will challenge players unlike any other region. Traversing the islands of the Devil's Roar is easier said than done. You and your crew will have to tackle earthquakes that will throw you off balance. You'll have to avoid searing lava flows and blasts from geysers that can throw you up into the air as a fiery inferno of red-hot rocks rain down from the sky. You'll also have to deal with superheated water around islands during volcanic eruptions. A dip in this water could prove deadly for even the most hardened pirate. And that's where our next feature comes in handy. The rowboat. Rowboats have started to wash up on the shores of all of the regions in the Sea of Thieves, and players can take them with them on their adventures by docking them to their ship. Use them to navigate the superheated water of the Devil's Roar, or perhaps to make shuttling your hard-earned loot back to your ship that little bit easier. You can also use them to speed up your resource gathering. Each rowboat has a small chest that can be loaded with the resources that you find on islands, making getting those vital bananas and planks of wood back to your ship easier and more efficient. The rowboat will also come into play in our new quest type, cargo runs. New characters within the Sea of Thieves need you to deliver items for them. The items they give you require care and attention to get them to their destination safely. Fragile rum bottles that'll smash if you're too heavy-handed. Luxurious cloth that'll rot if it gets wet. And plants that have to be watered to ensure they make it to their destination alive. The condition of your cargo determines the amount of gold you'll receive upon delivery. And what does a good pirate do with their riches? They spend them, of course! And if you're after a bargain, you might want to do that at one of the many new sea posts that have popped up around the Sea of Thieves. These makeshift shops carry a small assortment of random items, but all are on sale for a discounted price. What's not to like? And by exploring the Devil's Roar and completing Devil's Roar voyages and cargo runs, you can unlock the Ocean Crawler, Kraken, and Forsaken Ashes sets. With new equipment, clothing, and liveries, you can kit your crew out to strike fear into the hearts of less fashion-savvy sailors. And as you explore the new islands of the Devil's Roar, a part of the history of this region will be revealed as you encounter those who remain of the very first crews to chart these waters and uncover the tragic fate that befell them. The Forsaken Shores update is out now, free to all players. So ready your rowboats and maybe stock up on bananas as you journey into the danger of the Devil's Roar. Good luck!
Thank you very much for watching. If you want to stay up to date with everything Sea of Thieves, then subscribe to our channel and click that little ship's bell for all those notifications. Cheers. Don't worry, I'll just wait here. I'm not doing much anyway. Couple of good videos there if you want to watch.